Hi everyone, I'm back again with another storage solution. This time it's going to be for Copic markers. I guess it could be for other types of markers as well. Mandy needed one for her Copic, so this is what we've come up with. So what I'm doing first, okay, so I'll have the measurements and part instructions below in the description, a link to the document there, once I've finished it all, because I haven't worked it all out yet. But to start off with, we're going to need 5 sheets of medium weight chipboard cut to 5.5 by 4 inches. Then we want 1 piece cut at 4 by 4. And then we need 8 pieces of chipboard cut at 5 inches by 1/2 inch. And then we need 4 cut to 3 inches by 1/2 inch. So what we're going to do first, oh, and you'll also need a piece of A4 or 8.5 by 11 cardstock for the hinges, plus some Aileen's tacky glue, plus some bulldog clips. Right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to glue each of these 5.5 inch strips, sorry, together like that, and I just sort of spread that glue around like that, straighten it up, get the bulldog clips, help it stay together while that glue dries. I'll do that 4 more times for these long strips, or the 5-inch strips. Now, I've got a ring in here, I only want 4. These are 3-inch by 1/2-inch strips. Right, they're all done. Now, while they are drying, what we can now do is make our hinge strips. So just take your either your A4 or your 8.5 by 11 cardstock, cut it down to 9.5 inches, and then what we want to do is cut 8 1-inch strips. So 1, 2. Chuck that one. Get your scoreboard, and we're going to score these lengthways at the 1/2-inch mark. So in half at the 1/2-inch mark. For all 8 of them. And now we're going to put our score tape. I like to put mine on the edge, both edges there. If you have 3/8-inch tape, that's probably where you want to use it on this, but I don't, so I'm just going to put the 1/4-inch tape on the edges there. Do that to all 8 pieces. Okay, now we want to burnish that tape onto the hinges, and then fold it over and press that crease down. 1 hinge done. Do that to all 8. now they're done, what we need to do is put your hinge in your trimmer and cut off at the 4-inch mark. That way you've got a 4-inch hinge and you've got a 5.5-inch hinge. Do that to all 8 hinges. Right, now with the long hinges, the 5.5-inch one, I thought I only did 7. Okay, with the 5.5-inch ones, all we're going to do is mitre one end of them. At this stage, it doesn't matter which end. And I'm just coming down about 1/2 inch and cutting to the corner. So 1/2 inch down on the bottom edge, the open edge here, up to the folded corner edge, and that's what you should have there. So there, like that, okay? Just one end of these 5.5-inch hinge strips. Right, now with the 4-inch, we're going to mitre both ends the same way on all 8 of them. Right, now all that's done, we can start putting the unit together, and remembering that this is only one unit we're making. There are 9 of these units plus some. Okay, so let's take our 5.5 by 4-inch pieces. That's the way they're going to go, like that. Okay, put these to a side for now. So what we can do is take our, well, let's do this piece first, the back. This 4 square-inch piece is the back, so we're just going to take one of the 4-inch hinges, put it on either that 4-inch piece or back end of that 5.5-inch piece, remove the other side, take backing, butt them up end to end and push over your hinge. So that's going to be like that, so that's your back. Okay, right, now we can put the sides on. And they're the ones we're going to use, the longer strips, the 5.5-inch. Now, we turned around like that. That's your back here. So the front, there's not, that's going to be an open edge. So we want our straight edge of our hinges to be out there and our mitered ends to be down here, so that when it joins onto that one, it won't add any bulk. So what I usually do is line it up to the top edge first. And then wherever it lands down the end is where it lands, because I don't want it overhanging at the front. Okay, so that's it there. Now, get another one of your 5.5 by 4-inch pieces. Line it up flush and press that down. Now we're going to do the same to the other side here. So again, another of your 5.5-inch hinges. And press it down. Remove your tape backing from the other one. Butt it up. And press that down. Alright, so that's what we've got so far. Okay. Now what we want to do, we can actually put so to join these two here in the middle on the inside, we want to put some of the 4-inch strips or hinges on. So you can put them either on here or on here. I think I'm just going to put them on the 4 square-inch piece there. Don't remove your tape backing from the other one yet. so they will join up to them, the sides there on the inside. Okay, so now what we need to do is get our Timmy ruler or any clear ruler that has a centering section, a pencil. Now what we're going to do, because we're going to have a shelf inside here halfway up the sides like that, okay, so like that. All right, so we know these are 4 inches across, so it'll be at the 2-inch mark. So I'm just gonna make a mark on the chipboard at the 2-inch mark, and one in the center. Do the same to the other side. Oops. And then you want to draw a line from those marks which is made. And that's going to act as your guide. Now while we're at it, what I'm going to do, so we're going to have this piece is going to have to butt up into here anyway, so I want to put an extra support there. So I'm just going to find the center of this. Again, it's 2 inches, so now that's where these come in. So these should be dry by now. Now what I tend to do is, if there is any glue seepage, I just tend to scrape that off with my craft knife. Disclaimer, just be careful when you're using your craft knife. So I take two of them at a time and glue them on one side. And what we're going to do is going to butt it up at the front end, very close to that line we've just drawn, and just set it there. Do the same to the other one on the other side. Okay, so it's going to be flush at the front. Okay, we need that room there for the hinge to sit onto. So, okay, so now what I'm just going to take this, one of these 5.5 by 4 inch pieces, and sit that in there and push these up against it, making sure that we're lined up. So I know it's lined up there, and bring that over there so it's in alignment. What you can do is use your craft mat, your craft mat there if you want, making sure that it's lined up straight. I think that's pretty good. So just pressing on that and see if you take it out. I actually am over a bit too close on that back end, so let's do this again. Okay, so these, you've got a little bit of time with your wet glue to work your magic with this to get it straight. Now this is the fiddliest part of making these units, but I think there's less bulk in making them this way than actually making two separate boxes joined together. So, all right, I'm happy with that now. I'm going to let it dry and we're going to get on to the other side here. So let's take these off. Scrape it off. One. Right, I'm going to line it up, that line that I've drawn there on my darker line on my craft mat. Sit this down on that line, in line with that, because it's hard to see both ends at the same time. So, press that down. And making sure that it's flush at the front, it's not overhanging. Take it out, and that looks perfect to me, I think. But I'm just helping it along its way. Oh, making sure that I've left enough space for that piece to sit in there. But we don't want it loose, we want it snug. Okay, that's why. There we go, that looks good. All right, they can dry there, and we'll do these 3-inch ones. Now, I want a half an inch either side so that these hinges can be butted up. Actually, I could have probably done that right to the end, but it doesn't matter. All right, so glue these down in the same way. So we're just going to center these on that line, a half an inch roughly, either from each side. Where'd the other one go? Oh, I haven't undone it yet, have I? Wrong one. So basically up against the edge of the hinges that are already attached. So that looks mighty fine to me. And then if we sit that in there, and I've drawn that line longer than is necessary, which is good because then I've got a an idea as to where I need to position these. Okay, so that to me looks pretty darn good. Making sure that's going to sit in there snug, take it out and let it dry. Okay, I'll be back when that's dried enough so that we can put it all together. So while this is drying, I thought I might take one of the remaining two pieces of 5.5 by 4 inch chipboard, and because it's going to be adhered both inside and out, isn't it? So what I might do with that then, okay, we'll do the outside first. So just the back and two sides. So remembering that the front is the straight edge of the hinge. And for the outside hinges, I like to have this hinge. It's going to join the outside edges together, just over, sitting just slightly over the edge of that piece. So, okay. So on the inside we're going to need to put it. So what we could do is bring back this. Now we could either butt it up with this one, which is probably going to be easiest, right? So what we need to do now is get two more hinges and we'll put one on. So this is going to up there, so oops, we need, yep, making sure you position the mitered edge on the back end, okay, because the front's straight, so that's going to sit up like that. So we need another one on here. Okay, the mitered end that way. Right, so they're like that, and then we need one on this end. Okay. Now, so they're going to be, okay, what I want to do with these, they may not require it, but I noticed with a couple of my other ones that it did. I'm just going to put a V wedge here, so that when they go over there like that, okay, not really. What I want to do is just take a little bit of that off, just because it might butt up against your strips there. Just the tiniest little bit. Okay, on both sides. Okay. Let's do this. Jen. So when that sits up there, oh nice, okay. Okay, that's good, and good, all right. We can put this together now. So that's the outside. That's gonna go there like that. So we can put this one together. We'll do the top of this first. Butt that up against there, press it down, And that is going to go over there like that. What have we got here? Oh, okay. Yep. All right. Now, what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to do the sides first. And then once I do the sides, I can put the last piece of the 5.5 by 4 where they're going, where it's going to sit to help it stay up. All right. So let's do this one first. Line it up so that they're kissing the edges. Okay. And then press it. Oh, did I do that right? Yep. Phew. Okay, now this one I'm going to do like that, making sure the edges line up. Okay, they're done. Now we can put, slot this in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just do that. And that hopefully will line up with that one down there and slot in, and it has. Okay, so that's there like that. Now this one, we can take these off. These are the inside hinges. Okay, so I just want to make sure that they're lined up and kissing rather than overlapping. So there and there. And then let's get my ruler and add a little bit of a burnish. And then this one there, and there, and if we just do that, okay, so that's what we've got so far. So now we can strengthen it by remove the tape backing from this, the top of it. Okay, and then before I glue that down, I'm just going to get some Scotch Quick Dry and put in the gaps there. Hey. Just to give it a little bit extra support. And we want to roll that over. Over and then roll that over, and now give it a good old fashioned burnish. Okay, now is put the remainder of our hinges on. Oh, oops, wrong one. Maybe do it this way. So here, remembering that this is where we want to overhang the hinge slightly, and the straight edges at the front. Put some more wet glue in that groove. And then fold it over, burnish it. And this last one here with the long strips. Oops, wrong end. That's the way it goes. Over. patient. All right, now our remaining three 4-inch strips. Voila, one unit done. Okay, so I need to make 9 of these, and then so 3 side by side on the bottom, in the middle, and on the top, and then on the top of that we're going to have 4 individual boxes. We're not going to do the divider for the top, and it's going to be just 2 inches, and they're going to be 3 inches rather than 4 inches, but we'll get to that when we get to that. So they're going to be joined side by side, okay, glued together, and then on top of it I'm going to put a complete piece of chipboard right along to give it some extra strength. So that's what we have there. Okay. So there we go. So far. All right, gotta do the rest. I'll be back.